Good morning, dear students. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today I am going to explain about the keys of 19th dated assignments. Okay, the topic is diversity in living world. Fine. So the question number one, it asks that cylindrates are also known as dash. Okay, cylindrates are also known as cnidaria. We know them. They are also known as cnidaria. The C is silent. We term them as cnidaria. Why? Because of the presence of very special cells in them, which are cnidoblasts. Okay, that is why cylindrates are also termed as cnidaria. Now, question number two, it asks that in cnidaria, the body is made up of dash layer of cells. So the answer is, in cnidaria, the body is made up of two layers of cells, okay? Two layers, the outer ectoderm and the inner endoderm. They don't have that three layer of body organization. They have just two layer of cells, ectoderm and endoderm, and that is separated with the help of a layer that is termed as mesoglia. So they have two layers of body. Now, the question number third, it asks which species of cnidaria lives in colonies. Okay, which species of cnidaria lives in colonies? The answer is corals. Okay, corals are the species of cnidaria which lives in colonies. They are marine animals. They are present in seawater, and the individual corals are called as polyps. Okay, the individuals are called as polyps, but collectively their colonies are termed as corals. Now, the question number four, it asks, name any two examples of cnidaria which shows solitary habitat. That means two examples of cnidarians which show solitary habitats. That means they are basically present at one place. Okay. Answer, first one is hydra, which is actually attached to stones or twigs or something. It does not move here and there. And the second example is jellyfish. Okay, jellyfish. Not all the jellyfishes are moving. Some of the jellyfishes, basically they are attached to the seabed. Okay, so the answer is hydra and jellyfishes. Now, question number five, it asks, dash phylum represents organism with flat worms. Dash phylum. So, which phylum represents organisms with flat worms? They are Platyhelminthes. Answer is Platyhelminthes. We know that these are flat worms, okay? Their body is flat, okay? And nutrients passes through their body by diffusion, fine? So, the answer to question number 5 is Platyhelminthes, which represents flat worm, okay? Now, the question number 6, the body plan in Platyhelminthes shows dash symmetry. The body plan in Platyhelminthes shows bilateral symmetry. What is the meaning of bilateral? That means the body can be divided into two equal halves. Bilateral means the body of the organism, it can be divided equally into two equal halves. So the Platyhelminthes shows bilateral symmetry. Question number 7, name the phylum which shows the tissue level of organization. Okay, name the phylum. That means tissue level means no organs are present, only tissue level, lots of different tissues are present. So the answer is again cnidaria. Okay, cnidaria, and this phylum has only tissue level. That means the body consists of tissues only. The tissues have not grouped together to form any specific organs. Okay, they have specialized tissues. The most special is cnidoblasts or cnidocytes, which is used for the catching prey. Now, question number 8, dash are either free living or parasitic. So who are either free living or parasitic? Again the answer is these platyhelminthes. That means platyhelminthes consist of all the worms, the flat worms. Okay, so they are either free living or parasitic inside the other organisms. Now the question number 9, it asks, give an example of a free living flatworm, a free living and a parasitic platyhelminthes, that means flatworm. So question number 9, the answer is planaria. Okay, planaria is a flatworm which is the example of free living platyhelminthes or flatworm, and a parasitic platyhelminthes is liver fluke. Okay, liver, as the name suggests, it is basically a parasite of livers in all maximum mammals as well as humans. So liver fluke is a parasite of other organism. It lives inside the liver of most of the mammals including humans. Now the question number 10, identify the figure A and B. Identify. So the figure A is like this, having these kind of tentacles. This foot is present. Okay, so like this the tentacle. So this is actually A. Figure A is Hydra. Okay, Hydra. And it has, as I told you just now, it is attached to the stones or twigs with the help of its basal foot, and this is the tentacles which, with the help of which, it catches its prey, okay, its food. And the second figure is somewhat bulky and they have smaller tentacles like this, the very small tentacles, and this is basically sea anemone. Okay, sea anemone. The figure B is of sea anemones. Again, this thing is the tentacles with which it attacks and it catches its prey. Fine. So I hope, students, you have understood the keys, the answers of all the questions which I explained. Thank you, dear students. Bye for now. Thank you.